Alright.
Superfood Narbros, they take their name from somewhere. We're not gonna talk about where.
Yeah, no.
Alright, so was game one the Omega? Oh no, we're going to actual Pokemon Stadium 2 for game one. I can't believe that's what we struck.
This should be great.
Yeah. So, we've got the Sheik Ganondorf Zelda team.
Yeah.
For the Shinesparkers. Surprisingly, even though they have a Metroid name and a Zelda team.
Yeah.
What?
What?
Okay, did we just see that?
Yes.
That just happened.
Everyone was buried. Oh my god.
Robear buried everyone.
Yeah.
And then G-Man just killed his own teammate. Yeah. This is the most eventful 40 seconds of a match I've seen. Actually, we're just 32 seconds in.
No. Okay, so.
Oh,
Rover
picks up the down smash to forward smash, but didn't get the kill from but did.
Even
with that wizard drop kick, it still wasn't enough horizontal recovery to make it back.
Yeah. Oh, he tries to go for the down air spike.
And Jaxus picks up the up smash on Rover, catching him out of that flip kick, calling on it.
Oh, yeah. Robo trying to go for the flip kick, but G-Man deny it with more like drop kick.
Yeah, good job. Good on G-Man. Oh, but Brobear picks G-Man. Oh, but G-Man's really excellent to DI. DI transport all that into horizontal momentum.
Plus, you know, just Ganondorf every way.
Yeah.
So,
Sheik needling her teammate there.
Zero, the only one being with the third stock, but relatively high percent, so he could use it fairly quickly.
Oh my god!
Yes, but it looks like Brobear picked up a really good forward smash on both of the enemies at once.
Yeah.
G-Man getting a little desperate for that down air spike on Churro. Mm. Really could finish him off with anything, just an F tilt. A fair would work as well.
Go figure. Alright, so each character is down to the second stock. But it seems as though Fantari brothers are a bit of a lead, just considering Churro at super low percent.
Also, G-Man is actually on his last stock right now.
Oh wow, yeah, I didn't know that. Perhaps
he
is.
He got caught with two boost kicks, or... No, it was a boost kick and then a...
Forward smash?
Yeah, the forward smash.
Yeah. So yeah, G-Man on his last stock.
Oh, gets that accidental footstool on Mario.
Oh, and life snaps. If being able to recover.
Oh wow, G-Man failed to pick up that follow-up on Mario there.
And Jaxus saves G-Man,
but not for long. Robear picks up the boost kick KO. Now Jaxus is in a 2v1 scenario. Not a very good one, because there are two stocks on both the enemies.
Yeah.
Though he has two on himself, that's still not a very good position. It's 4-2.
But I have seen Jaxus, beat a 2v1 barely, I don't want to say easily, because I'm sure he was working his butt off.
Yes, but another thing to keep in mind is that both these players are really good. This isn't just, you know, I mean, Jaxus did pick up a solid backer there, but he's looking at 160% himself, and that's all it takes to finish him off, too.
But, no, this is still, he can still pull this off.
Yeah, he's got to work for it.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Rover hitting Churro with the flip kick.
Yeah. A little bit of friendly fire, that's what happens when friendly fire is on. Jaxus is trying to take control of the center of the stage, which is the part of the stage you want to have control of here. And he's playing this 2v1 smart. What you want to do in a 2v1 scenario is you want to split up the enemies, because that way they can't punish anything you do to the other one.
And then they just end up hitting each other.
Yeah. It's dangerous because it means you have to get in the middle of them, but it's what you want.
Going for the bouncing fish, trying to finish it. Churro off.
Jaxus finds that up air. Churro's Churro did that air dodge, and Jaxus right, but Robear.
Forward air, I think, was it?
That was a back air.
Back air, I can't tell. I don't know ZSS.
ZSS's forward air is two kicks, whereas the back air is just one really powerful kick like that.
As it was.
Yep, with those rocket booster high heels.
Yeah.
Not something you want to get kicked with. Well, game one's going to go to Super Futanari Bros.
Yep.
This is still a best of five. Winner's finals here.
Oh boy, you're going to be here for a while.
Yeah, well, that would actually be what I'd hope to see. Hope to see an interesting set that goes back and forth.
Oh yeah. Just watch it go to game 5 and then they go to sudden death. Just ultimate ending.
We've had some really close sets in the past. I remember me and Shai did one a while ago where it was game 5 and it was a 1v1 at the end. And it was a trade final hit.
I remember that.
Yeah.
I had to go watch it back on YouTube again just to actually see what happened.
Yeah, it was insane. But, you know, focus is on this match. So, do you expect to see any character switches here?
There might be one, where G-Man might go back to DD and Jax is to either Sheik or Pikachu.
Yeah. I don't know if they feel confident going off on their more main characters against this team.
Yeah.
Super Fruit and Naruto is possibly the second strongest, if not strongest, team here today.
Yeah.
The others being the Shiny Sparkers, of course.
Yeah. Very team work much. I can speak.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, the higher you go in the bracket, the better the players, and the less freedom you have to go off of characters you randomly play. And this is
more pressure.
These are the only two teams that were never eliminated once yet.
Wow.
So, go. Well, so far, it looks like Robear is trying to hold stage control down, but the Shine Sparkers were able to find it back.
Ooh,
and
oh,
that up air.
That was up air, dang it, I can. It's an up air. I swear!
It's an up air from G-Man. It was the backwards hitting part of the swing.
Yeah.
So. Blue team trying to find a way into a more stage control position right now. They're definitely being placed on the edge by Mario Rose.
Going for the boost kick, but misses entirely.
Yeah, but Mario picked up a kill on G-Man with that back throw.
Yeah.
Mario's back throw is a kill throw at those kinds of percent to the edge.
Very much so. Oh, Jax is going for the up air, but Churro remains to air dodge.
Yep. The thing about air dodging those up airs is you gotta do it right when you know it's coming.
As soon as it initiates.
Oh, Robear picks up the second hit of the flip kick.
Yep.
So, we're looking at green team at the advantage right now, hanging out with 5-stop.
Okay, stocks
are even again. Yep. But something Jax is super good at doing, and somehow all the players here have just still never learned not to air dodge when Jax is below them.
Yeah.
Like, they air dodge, and he's like, he sees it, he just jumps up with that up air and gets them. But I still do it, and I kick myself every time.
God darn it! Why did you do that? I know.
I'm sure that's what Churro's doing right now, but it wasn't too big of a deal because he still had 3 stocks at the time.
Yeah. Oh, percentage-wise and stock-wise, the pairs are fairly even, except for not now. Yes. G-Man gets that forward tilt.
Yeah, you got that Sparta kick. This is Sparta.
This is Hyrule.
Yes.
Oh, and Jax saves it from the back throw.
And
back air takes it.
Back air from Churro, yeah. I'm surprised, you know, in spite of being a heavyweight, it seems like G-Man's getting his stocks lost to a lot of moves that don't strike me as the strongest kill moves, you know?
Yeah, it's surprising. I mean, I guess Rage Effect with Churro.
Yeah.
That 90 now. Not sure what it was earlier.
G-Man had to recover there, and the only way to do it was to hit Jaxus. Then he caught Jaxus with the up air, so. Things are not looking good for the Shinesparkers right now, although that was awesome.
Okay, they play wisely. It's still anyone's game, because Ganondorf heavyweight, and it's anyone's game still.
Yeah. Of course, whenever that happens, we have to say to Ganondorf, give him the boost.
If the boot fits.
Oh, G-Man totally called out that up B and punished it hard.
Yes.
G-Man getting caught in the gravity grenade. Jax didn't do too much damage there.
Not quite. G-Man just being juggled all over the place.
And the melee.
Forward tilt.
It looks like this suddenly is looking in blue team's favor, although it's definitely not out of Churro's. You know, actually, it's not really that much of blue team's favor just because the percents are in Churro's favor.
Yeah.
If you can get the stock off on G-Man, it turns into a 1v1. Mm-hmm. And we've seen Churro take stocks off Jaxus plenty of times before.
Oh, yeah, very much.
He's going to have to play this 2v1 a little safer.
A little bit. As we say that, he just dash attacks everyone.
Jax is trying to pick up the edge guard.
Both players of the blue team are being very defensive.
And Jaxus gets it with that gravity grenade to up smash. Grade. Game 2 does go to the Shine Sparkers. Wrapping up with that classic combo.
Oh yeah. Gravity grenade, up, sweet spot, up smash. Oh no. As you might have predicted, the bracket reset may occur.
What now?
As G-Man announced, the bracket reset just may occur.
Flying Llamas in the Darkness, who won that game?
Flying Llamas.
Flying Llamas, Travis, you have to go play. Go play Egg Lay to low roll.
Alright, so when he's signing off.
So Flying Llamas 2-1. 2-1.
Nice.
What is signing off? Yeah. He's gonna be stepping out with me though.
It's too
hard, actually. We're gonna get Wolfie. Do you want to go with Wolfie or do you want to go with Wolfie? Alright, guys, I'm being joined by one of our Yoshi players.
Playing the Flying Llamas.
This is Wolfie. So Wolfie, you're picking up in the middle of the winner's final set.
Okay.
We're going into game 3. It looks like it's happening at Lilac.
Yoshi hoodie with Yoshi on it and the other guy with the Doctor Who shirt. Okay.
So, you know, one thing that I see all the time is whenever Tro has Lilac active, he's going to go Villager. This is definitely a counter pick that they specifically went for with the action in mind of switching to Villager.
Right. Villager is a tricky character.
Yeah, and he works good on Lilac because of those buildings. He has zero trouble recovering and controls a lot of the space with his projectiles around those platforms and stuff.
Yeah, this would seem like a good Villager stage.
So far, percents are looking pretty even on both teams.
Yeah.
That was close!
But, there we go. Villager playing that tree. I think that he's working with no customs because I don't see it flashing, so that is not the trip tree.
Yeah.
Especially since he grew it fully now.
Yeah, it's definitely
not
the trip
tree. Oh. Wow, what trade was that? Did you see that?
I think that was
Villager's up smash, right?
Yeah, that was Villager's up smash, but I don't know what Ganondorf hit with.
Interesting. Oh, we do have the exploding balloons active, so maybe that is the trip tree, and I just can't see very well.
No, I don't think it's the trip tree. I think I saw, like, it glowing up, and Ganondorf killed himself.
Yeah, he got scared out of recovering or something.
Yeah.
Tro picking up his ledge camping Villager tactics. Oh, and he gets that bowling ball.
It's hard to get that bowling ball.
Yeah, he just held it. And the tree! That was an amazing team combo.
Yeah.
Pro-Bear just hit. Pro-Bear hit Jaxus right into it. G-Man complaining about getting juggled a little too much, too.
Looks like Futanami is in the lead by a large stock.
Yeah, they've got two stocks up on them right now. It's 5 on the green team side to 3 on the blue team side. So Super Food Mario Bros. Counterpick is working out for them, right? CSS is trying to pick up that up air string, but didn't quite do it. And there's the boost kick. The crowd's getting pretty excited for it.
Yep.
Oh. Bro-Bear likes to try to go for raw boost kicks when he thinks people are going to shield drop him or something like that. It didn't work out for him.
Right? Oh, gets him with the... Got Jaxus with the smash.
Oh, good.
Now it's just G-Man all by himself.
They're going to try to go for one of their team combo type things. G-Man's got quite the hill to climb. Normally, I like to say you can't count someone out, but 5 stocks to 1.
Yeah,
against players like Bro-Bear and Tro, I don't think G-Man has much of a chance.
Got the Dark Fist.
But he's going to fight. He's going to try to get off as many stocks as he can. He's doing it! Yeah. Bro-Bear took him all the way to the top.
Yeah.
Well, game 3 is going to the Super Fruit Eyebrows.
That was legit.
What adjustments do you think the Shine Sparkers need to make?
Hopefully pick a better stage. Probably one that doesn't. That's not Lylat.
Yeah. I doubt they'll go back to Lylat.
Yeah.
They have the counter pick this time. Last time it was the Scorpion and Eyebrows that took our stage. So.
Right.
Who won?
Save the Annals. 2-0.
Alright, Save the Animals versus Mistfire to the Moon!
Alright, I'm gonna be stepping off.
Dino
is gonna be joining. Dino's gonna be joining Wolfie on commentary. Go play my match. Good luck to both teams.
Is Leo here?
It's like sure switching to Mario. Looks like the other two are staying.
ZSS,
why is the question here?
Okay, so round 4 begins of winners finals. And Shine Spark picked this stage for something. Picked Omega Kalos. Wonder why. Anyway,
Jax is really garaging Jura right there.
Yeah, he is.
Not getting anything for Stock, particularly. But just 8% lead.
Oh! Hit G-Man with a down B, Robear.
Missing the bouncy fish. Leo's bouncy fish.
Oh wow. Just avoided the. Grover just
shield
pop
to fall to death.
Wow. That's the first time I've seen that.
Goose kick, GT now very quiet.
Oh, gets
forward tilt for Stock.
Oh, wow.
She loses her Stock. This looks more like a slaughterfest, honestly.
Yeah, it's definitely more even than the last match. Looks like Shinesburg has a slight advantage for stent-wise.
If Jax doesn't get hit, then that is an advantage.
Gets the bouncing fish.
For kill. Raw bouncing fish for kill. That's pretty good. AJ not screwing around this time. If Jax is not screwing around this game, getting kills when he absolutely can, rather than just continually poking his enemy to death.
Up smash kills G-Man.
Whereas up smash is a very solid kill move.
Yeah, it's really good.
Difficult to challenge because the head is full.
Right.
And his head's busted in the way. Shine Sparkers have a stock lead of 1 stock. raw damage roll will be dead of Jaxus and stuff.
This looks extremely close.
It's pretty close. Bro Bear stock ready to go.
Very much.
A kill percent of 130.
Whoa, I got a bad grab.
Both Ganondorf and ZSS are very much in kill percent, ready to go.
Yeah, but Ganondorf.
Ganondorf may be heavy, but he can certainly still die.
Yeah.
Broker saving Rick the G-Man there.
Yeah, by Rick.
By breaking the G-Man with a death attack. That's it for G-Man stock. Now it's just a 1v1 Jaxus feature of R.O.D. Sheik. Sheik character who generally pokes and uses safe moves, which makes it difficult for Mario to kill because his kill moves are really more of a... You need to get a read for them to connect correctly, I guess. Well, not connect correctly, but...
Oh!
I eat my words. Smash. And what's that? Super Free Night Bros take... Yep. Not singles, this is 7 finals. They take 7 finals.
Yep.